Hey everyone, welcome back to Spell Only Demon Souls. It's been a hot minute since I've recorded this playthrough, but we need to, you know, get going here. I made it back to the Nexus since the last episode because we have some new NPCs. I did talk to some of these guys because I forgot that there was that issue with the audio last time around, so I paused and I stopped the recording to check if everything is working, and everything is working, it seems. Although we had a mid-episode issue last time around as well. So, I talked to Yuria already. Holy shit, I'm yawning already. It's fucking midday, what the hell? Okay, she only has soul thirst. Increases souls gained from defeated foes. No, I thought she would have more, honestly. So what we're gonna do is we are going to get the homing soul arrow. This shit is way better than soul thirst, and that is putting it lightly. So I think we can get rid of this and what? This and what? Damn. I don't like having to get rid of Soul Arrow. This is, by the way, this spell, Homing Soul Mass, it's called in the other games. Yeah. What the hell? Do you see how her sliding around? Cool. This is what we're gonna do. Okay, so no matter what I do, I cannot get more magic memory, which is okay, because we have another avenue, and that avenue is rings. I think we are going to be okay without the fragrant ring. Oh shit, I deposited it, didn't I? Damn, this thing lasts for quite a while, timing-wise. Ring of magical nature, that's the one. And I think I'm going to get soul arrow back. You want your most basic spell, right? Cool. I am pretty happy with the setup. Let's go ahead and continue in the game where I think we are going to head to... We need more fresh spice as well. Can't believe it. Does this shit just like last forever? Anyways, we're going to Stonefang too, because why not? Red Hot Demon Soul. I think that can be made into Firestorm by Yuria, which is like one of the most powerful spells in the game. Most powerful spell that's probably going to be like too much MP cost wise, or even slot cost wise. Yes, I did get blown up by the cart, and I was reminded that we've seen this section already because I've... Holy shit. I've come in here to kill this fat official before. That is more damage than I was expecting. I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. Anyways, there's very few things that I like legit need in this area. So I am going to try speedrunning my way through here. Come on. Come on. Okay, whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna try speedrunning my way through here. And then we'll just see what happens. We gotta get patches as well, because he comes after us here, and it's just kind of annoying, because you do lose him from the Nexus until you sort of do his quest line again. I love the redesign of this area. I've talked about this before. I think they really, really nailed this. And of course, these worms can get fucked. Normally, they are kind of annoying. But not with this build. Oh, shit. Damn, Crystal deserves our resistance to magic, but not to fire. Okay, that's good to know. Not that I needed this, but I don't know. I was bloodlusted for that crystal lizard. That poor thing. What the shit? Floating treasure, nice. Nice. So I think we're going to be... I should have checked. I thought that that was where you drop. That is not where you drop. Cool. Lesson learned. Lesson learned. Okay, so this time around, I'm really going to try to not like suicide myself off of the ledge. That is the goal for this episode. Because this is where you drop. I don't even know what kind of like stoner shit I was on, thinking that that's where you drop. Yeah. Not the smartest today, I'm guessing. Which is risky because that probably means I'm gonna do a lot of dumb shit in this episode, and that's never a good thing. But hey, that's what we're destined for, some dumb shit. That's what we're gonna do. I should have deposited all these. But you know, being able to move it to storage is very helpful. I do like that feature. Again, there's absolutely nothing here that we really actually need. Hey, Patches. You are creepy as fuck. Cool. I'm gonna get your treasure because you're such a nice guy. So, I mean, technically, he wasn't lying. He does give you treasure. It just comes with a caveat, you know. Oh, damn, that is... That does a lot of damage, but talk about the MP costs. I think I said something about going to farm H-Spice. As you can very clearly tell, I've not been to do that. What a fascinating battle. Yeah, these things don't even do anything. Badass explosion, though. That is really cool, actually. Bear bug, what? That is something new. Holy shit. I got magic patches. What did you think? Very useful though, what it gives you. You can get two of these. Okay, so what is this? An actual all guys soul remains kunai. What the hell? What is that? Is that a... I didn't see... I definitely picked it up. Oh, it probably got moved into my storage, right? Because I'm overburdened. Yeah. It's probably what's going on here. I gotta watch my HP too, because... I ain't exactly loaded. Normally, I do go back into human form, but... I feel like there is a risk of me dying again in this place, and I don't want to tend towards Black World tendency, if possible. No, shoot the... Okay, don't shoot the head then. This is not the best area in terms of conserving MP. Say the least, especially since normally this place is very useful because you have a bunch of good upgrade materials here, and for this run is just, yeah, get through this shit as quickly as you can. I am really, really curious about that, like bug remains or whatever. I do like that they added more items, and they are useful, and I'm going to use the last bright water I have, don't worry. It's just, I'm saving it for something special. Fuck. I'm just thinking. I should have attuned water veil. Shouldn't I? And I would have been good for the boss here. One of the issues with this area, why people tend to think that this is the hardest area, is that this is one of the hardest bosses in the game, I'd say. And there is no easy way here. No shortcuts, nothing. So you gotta track through this entire shit to get to the boss. So probably that's why this place lives a bit rent-free in people's heads as like the most difficult area in the game, where it's probably not. It's just, it's a big area. So you can like fuck around for a long time, but if you know your goal, you can just go straight to it. The only saving grace here for me, the reason I'm not worried, is that the boss here is mad weak to... Oh yeah, this thing has good fire defense, I remember. Is that it's mad weak to magic, so I don't really expect too much trouble. Especially like the soul type magic, that's what it's weak to. So... whatever. So again, I don't think we're going to be running into too big of a setback. And again, it's easy to get lost here. I'm kind of going off of sort of muscle memory. This feels like the right place, and I think it is. It don't just feel like it, it actually is. We're nearly there too, aren't we? Hold on, am I going the right way? No, I'm not. What are you doing, boy? This is where you're meant to go. And we're here. I don't need the hands of God. Fuck, the water veil thing is really... That's an oversight. And if we die because of it, I'm going to be pissed. God, one fucking... like 0.1 pound and it overburdens me. Strangely, healing items are very heavy in this game. Which technically doesn't make much sense. I know why they did it, but, you know, just logically. Because there is so much logic normally in Souls games. You know how it is. Logically, that shit makes no sense. The particles, man, that's really cool. This boss is sick now. It looks like a fucking demon of corn. Did I say that before? Man, I've played so many playthroughs of this game. I don't even know if I've said something. But this straight up looks like a Warhammer demon. Corn Berserker. That's not a demon, but you know. My Warhammer nerdiness is going through. Coming through. Most things I know because of Dawn of War. That shit is way too expensive, man. Like actual Warhammer. See? This guy. Sucks for him. Holy shit, nice dodge. Look at that, that's 155 damage. This is more reliable. Not taking any risks here. What's the point? Sorry, Flame Lurker. Normally you're a pretty big challenge, but not if you're using magic. You can seriously just beat this. If you're having trouble with this boss, you can just literally get the stats for Soul Arrow and you can beat him fairly easily. That's how much of a bitch this guy is to magic. Cool, let's head back to the Nexus. Before doing anything else, I'm going to confirm that my theory is true. Ignite. Oh no, she gives you combustion. She gives you firestorm from the thing. Wait, the heart demon is... Hold on. What the hell? Why did that show up? The heart demon is the armored spider. Yeah, that's where she gives you combustion. And the red hot demon soul is what we just got. Probably she doesn't give you anything from it because it's needed to make boss weapons. Yeah. Okay, well, whatever. Let's level up. Just go for this. Yeah, I'm just going for this. Let's not overcomplicate things. I feel like I should stock up on a half moon grass now. And once again, I have plenty of consumables. So let's use these up. We're definitely gonna level up more. 30. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Give me that doink magic capacity. And also, give me, well, first of all, repair my stuff. And also give me fresh spice. The only question is, what spell should we take? Probably just Soul Ray. I'm just looking at it practically. So yeah, I should probably rearrange my stuff. Cool, this is how we're going to do it. So I have, well, first of all, we don't need this. I have Soul Arrow, then Fire Spray to finish anything off, then Homing and Soul Ray, the two powerful spells, and Flame Toss as an alternative. That's kind of my logic behind what we're doing here. All right, Thief Ring on. Let's do the dragon. I don't want to do the dragon because I hate the dragon, but we gotta take care of it. I don't even know why they put this shit into this game, this stealth boss, but whatever. They learned their lesson. I mean, FromSoft stealth has progressed significantly since the days of Demon Souls, let me tell you. And you know, I read that Elden Ring is supposed to have stealth as well, which I'm actually really happy about. I've been looking into Elden Ring. I tried to stay away from stuff. Like, my general... Hold on a second. Yes, you can. My general... Is that broken? I think it is. My general attitude towards new Souls games or new From Software games is I like to stay away. What the hell? Bruh. Now it's broken, right? Now it's fucking hell. I like to stay away from information. Like, I want to go in there as fresh-faced as possible. I'm fucking out in the open. What am I doing? I don't know where we ended up there, but... I legit thought I was behind the pillar. The thing with this boss is there is absolutely no reason to go back into human form because it one-shots you either way, so who gives a fuck, you know? So yeah, back to Elden Ring. I like to go in there with as little knowledge as possible for a new FromSoft game, but I did look into Elden Ring a little bit. And it's looking good, boys. I know I made that video where I was a little bit skeptical. I think rightly so, to be honest. Because there was absolutely nothing on Elden Ring for so long that it... Please tell me I'm not out in the fucking open. I'm not. Like, it was gone for... There was nothing on it for so long that I was beginning to wonder what the hell is going on. And I think I'm not the only one that felt this way. But now that there's actual information on the game, things are looking mad good. And, you know, I like to be proven wrong. If it turns out, like, it's FromSoft, I trust them. I know it's going to be a doink game, so I'm not exactly worried with that aspect, but I think it's looking better than even I could have anticipated. Really, the thing is, it looks like they are pooling all their knowledge of all the other Souls games, like all the games that have come before, like Dark Souls, Demons, Dark Souls 2, Sekiro especially, and they're trying to make like a best of, which makes me really happy. Really, really happy. Please tell me this thing doesn't see me from here. I don't think it does. Okay, I'm gonna load up on MP just in case. This has always been my big issue with this boss, is that you cannot fucking tell where it's looking because it has the dragon eyes which go on the side. Like, it should, this thing should have like side vision. But I think it's measured by whether it's looking straight at you or not. Okay, phone. Shut up. I don't even know what the hell that number was. That was a US number. Fuck if I'm picking that up. As in like when I'm not expecting a call from the US. Come on, turn away. Turn away. Excellent. Oh shit, there's one more. Break this, break it, break it. I did not know there was one more. I did not. God damn it. Okay, do I have to do all this whole thing again? I think I do. Okay, here we go. This is where we sort of left off last time around. The real question here is it actually possible to break this pillar in time? I found out that using the fucking... I don't think it is. I don't think this is actually possible. Because, like... the flame toss breaks the pillars faster. But the question is, do we consider this cheating if I go with the crisp blade? Technically, I'm not killing an enemy, and I don't think I have a faster spell. I mean, Solar was a little bit faster, but... By the way, I had to turn on my light. It gets dark quickly nowadays. Yeah, we see with Solaroid takes 2 hits per, like, I don't know, like state of crumbling. So that's not gonna work. Yeah, we have to go with a real weapon here. There's no other way. Cool. Let's do this. This isn't considered cheating. Yeah. There's no wonder it does the fire attack. Because, like, the mechanic is supposed to be you breaking the last one quickly enough. This... whatever. I mean, this is a stupid boss, anyways. Cough. I was like, I'll just cut out the cough, but I realized we're in the middle of a cutscene. By the way, I didn't explain this, but the reason it got darker is I also got another phone call, which actually was important. I had a package arriving. So I went down, played with the dog a little bit, got him pumped up, played some fetch. So that's where I was. All right, Dragon. You can't even touch me. That was unintentional. Go! Go, orbs! Attack! It's pretty funny. Sorry, Dragon God. You're pretty cool. But you had to go. I really did not expect this fucking boss to be more difficult than the Flame Lurker. But then again, it kind of makes sense because this boss is hella random. They didn't learn their lesson and they tried again with the Bed of Chaos and that didn't work either. And then they abandoned the concept of a puzzle boss. I'm super curious about this. Ho 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 ho, there it is. There's the boy. Oh, fuck yeah, we're gonna get it. Like, what do you think? Let's just... No, we want fire spray. This thing. This thing is ridiculous. Like, actually ridiculous. Just look at it. Like, compare it to Firestorm in Dark Souls 1. Look at how many pillars there are and look at how, like, concentrated it is. This spell is absolutely, absolutely insane. Let's just also take care of our leveling needs. I think for a change, as we're advancing towards the end of the game, we don't need endurance, but let's do vitality a little bit. We're getting into the bosses where they start to get kind of tanky, or not tanky, but they hit hard. Yeah, I think I'm happy. I'm content. There's not much left to go. We have Penetrator, Dead Archstone, this Archstone, pain in the ass, and then the finale. Don't expect too many troubles. I did say, you remember at the start, I did say that this playthrough is going to cascade very quickly. It's very easy to become incredibly powerful as a sorcerer, and Firestorm is just step in the right direction. So if you did enjoy this video, make sure to give it a like, comment, subscribe, do all the usual, turn on post notifications to stay up to date with my content, and I will catch all of you next time. Take care and peace out.